Hello and welcome to the second video in the IORA Blue Carbon Hub video series. In the first video, we demonstrated how to take a core from inside a seagrass bed for the purposes of measuring organic carbon. In this video, we're going to show you how to do some calculations on the compression that we got when we retrieve that core and apply it to the samples that we get from the lab. In the first video, we showed how to hammer a PVC pipe into the seagrass meadow to get the core. If you haven't seen that video yet, I encourage you to watch it now. When we hammer the core into the seagrass, what we want is for the retrieved soil depth to be effectively the same inside the core as outside the core. But what almost always happens when we're hammering a PVC core in is that the retrieved soil depth will be lower inside the core than outside the core, so that there is some core compression. In this video, we're going to show you how to do some calculations to uncompress that. But first, we need the data that we collected, so let me go and get Anna. Thanks to the magic of video, we now have Anna, who you'll remember from the first video in the seagrass meadow. So in that video, we used a length of PVC pipe that was 150 centimeters. We also measured the length of pipe that was outside the sediment.
And which was 74 centimeters.
74 centimeters. And the length of pipe that was inside the core. And that was?
93.3 centimeters.
93.3. So now we need to do a little bit of subtraction to get the length of the retrieved core is the total length of the core minus the length of the core inside. I think I can do that in my head. 56.7 centimeters. We also want to know the amount of core that is in the sediment in total. And so that's also by subtraction, 150 minus 74. And again, I can do that in my head. We can get 76 centimeters. So in a situation where you want to be sampling in the lab what is effectively equivalent to 5 centimeters of an uncompressed core, you need to calculate what the equivalent length of core you should slice for the compressed core. To do that, we take our outside measurement divided by our inside measurement, which is, Anna?
0.746.
0.746. Then, let's say we want to take a 5 centimeter core, we want to multiply that to get the equivalent length, which would be
3.73.
So in the lab, if we wanted to get the equivalent to an uncompressed 5 centimeter slice of our core, we would want to take 3.73 centimeter slice. Conversely, if we wanted to take a 5 centimeter slice of our compressed core, what would be the equivalent length in the uncompressed core? To do that is simply reversing our equation. So that in this case, 76 divided by 56.7 is an
1.34.
And we apply that to our 5 centimeter slice. So 5 times 1.34 gives us an equivalent of
6.70.
6.70 centimeters in our uncompressed core. If you're only interested in calculating the total organic carbon stock in your retrieved core, it doesn't really matter which one of these you apply. It does matter if you're interested in calculating the carbon stock or the carbon density down the core profile. Then you'll want to think carefully about which of these approaches that you want to use. Also, note that normally we try to get at least a meter of PVC inside the ecosystem or the soil that we're trying to sample. We didn't manage to do that on this occasion. It happens. So there you have it. We now have all the numbers that we need to calculate core compression after you've sliced the sample in the lab. And that is what we'll be showing in the next video, when Anna will demonstrate slicing and preparing a core in the lab.
I'll see you in the lab.
And thanks for watching.